طبعا one point. بسم الله والحمد لله الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعليكم السلام وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تمسك بسنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد after praising Allah سبحانه وتعالى and sending the salutations upon the messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام and upon his companions and upon his family and upon all those who follow, upon his guidance into the establishment of the last day. To proceed, ikhwan, فَسُبْحَانَكَ لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا إِلَّا مَا عَلَّمْتَنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. Glory belongs to you, Ya Allah. Verily we have no knowledge except that which you have taught us. And indeed you, Ya Allah, you are the all-knower and the all-wise. The all-knower and the all-wise. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من علم لا ينفع ومن قلب لا يخشع ومن نفس لا تشبع ومن دعاء لا يسمع. Verily, Allah, we seek refuge with you from knowledge that has no benefit, and from a heart that has no fear, and from a soul that has no satisfaction nor contentment, and from a dua that goes unanswered, and from a dua that goes unanswered. To proceed, إخوان. فنواصل معكم في هذه الليلة المباركة الكريمة عونا من الرحمن الرحيم. So we continue in this blessed and noble night of ours, seeking the aid and the assistance of our Lord, the most merciful and the most compassionate. مذكرا نفسي وياكم, reminding ourselves firstly, and our brothers and our sisters secondly. مستفيدين ومتعلمين من شرح إمامنا وشيخنا Abi Abdullah al-Masna'i, Hafidhah Allah Ta'ala, as we continue to learn together and benefit from and educate ourselves from the words of our Imam, our Shaykh, who's known to us as Abu Abdullah al-Masna'i al-Yamani, وهو يشرح متن عقيدة إمامين الرازيين رحمهم الله تعالى رحمهم الله تعالى, as he comments and explains the text of the belief of the two Imams of Raazee, the two Imams of Raazee. فهل نفهم يا إخوان أنهما الوحيدان من علماء أهل السنة أم لا? Do we understand from this, يا إخوان, as we mentioned, there are two Imams of the Sunnah? Do we understand here that they are the only two Imams of the people of the Sunnah of the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام? من يجيب? Who can answer?
No.
الجواب لا. The answer is no, يا إخوان. ولكن هذان إمامان منهم رحمهم الله تعالى رحمهم الله تعالى. But what we understand, يا إخوان, is that these two Imams are from the Imams, from those who are upon the Sunnah of the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. وهم كثيرون وهم كثيرون. And they are numerous, يا إخوان. They are numerous. على كل على المسلم أن ماذا أن يحفظ وأن يدرس وأن يتعلم كتب هؤلاء رحمهم الله تعالى. So it's upon the Muslim to learn about the likes of these Imams and to memorize and to study their works حتى يسير على نهجهم على نهجهم فهم ماتوا على السنة رحمهم الله تعالى. So that the person can therefore traverse and travel and be upon their methodology and their understanding, for indeed they died upon the Sunnah of the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. طيب فمن هما? So who are they? هذان إمامان. أحسنت. تفضل شيخ. محمد ابن إدريس ومن? عبد الكريم. عبيد الله ابن عبد الكريم. أحسنتم يا أخوة أحسنتم. طيب, as we learn, these two Imams, the two Imams of Ar-Razi, they are Abu Hatim, Muhammad ibn Idris, and Abu Zura'a, Abdul Ubaidullah ibn Abdul Kareem. طيب, وهما من علماء السنة, خاصة في الحديث. And these Imams are from the Imams of the Sunnah, especially in the likes of الحديث وفي العقيدة. طيب, تعلمنا شيئا عن الإيمان, فما هو? So we learned something about belief. What did we learn about belief, يا إخوان? تعلمنا arba'ata ashya. We learn four things connected to belief. Shaykh Uthman.
By iman? Iman is speech.
The speech.
And actions.
Actions.
Increase and decrease.
Increase and decrease our sense. فَهَذَا مِنْ عَقِيدَةِ إِمَامِي أَوْ عَقِيدَةِ أَمَتِي السُنَّةِ. And that is from the belief of the Imams of the Sunnah. That iman consists of speech, actions, it increases and decreases. فَمَا هُوَ أَمْرٌ الَّذِي يَرَفَعَ الْعَبْدُ بِهِ إِمَانَهُ. It was an affair, Sheikh Rashid, that a Muslim by way of it can increase his iman.
Good deeds.
Ay, ata'a, ta'atullah, the obedience of Allah Ta'ala. Ay, amalin ma, idha yakunu min ta'atillahi ta'ala, idha al-abdu yaf'aluhu, wa yastamirru alayh, fayajidu imanahu zaidan. So any action of obedience, ikhwan, you name it. If it's obedience Islamically, in the sight of Allah Ta'ala, in the confines of the religion of Al-Islam, if the Muslim does it, especially if he's consistent upon it, and he makes it a practice, he's going to find that his iman is going to increase. كَمَا هُوَ الْأُمُورُ الَّتِي تُنْقِصُ أَوْ تُنْقِصُ إِمَانَ الْعَبْدِ. And what some of the things that can decrease?
مَعَاصِي.
مَعَاصِي. The sins, الظُّنُوب. وَأَيُّ شَيْءٍ يُؤَدِّي إِلَيْهِ. And likewise, those things that can lead to the sins also is going to affect the person's iman. طيب فما هو مثل من شيء يتعلق بالإيمان قولا. For our beloved new brother Abdul Malik. طيب. Something that is from speech that's connected to iman. We mentioned that iman is speech, actions. طيب. Speech, actions, it increases and decreases. Memorize that. Give us an example of something that's from iman of speech.
Alhamdulillah.
Hey, a dhikr. Alhamdulillah. Saying Alhamdulillah. All praise belong to Allah. Allahu Akbar. Allah is the greatest. La ilaha illallah. Nothing has the right to worship except Allah. Ayyu shay'in yakhruju min al-lisan. Anything that comes out of or from the person's tongue. وَمِثَالٌ آخر. Another example of قَوْلًا. Something of speech.
Allahu Akbar.
A dhikr. He mentioned dhikr. Something else.
Da'wah.
MashaAllah. Da'wah. Wa. Something else.
Reading
Quran. Hey, تَلَاوَةُ الْقُرْآنِ. طَيْبْ مِثَالًا مِنْ الْأَعْمَالِ. An action, an example from actions that are connected to iman.
Salah.
Salah. Ascent. Al-Siyam, fasting. Another example from actions.
Actions. Good deeds.
Good deeds. Alhamdulillah. Give us an example of one.
Give
us a four. Hey, sadaqa. Aina nahnu mina sadaqa. Where are we from sadaqa? Akthar al-Muslimin al-Yawm yakhrujuna qabla an sami'a or sami'u shay'an binisbati ila i'ta'i al-sadaqa. Most of us after Jumu'ah, especially us, in our communities, we leave the masjid. Salaamu alaikum, salaamu alaikum. Half the masjid is in the hallway before they hear the announcement of sadaqah or the likes. طيب إذا العبد يكون مشغولا فلا بأس إذا لابد أن يرجع إلى عمله أو إلى أهله لابد أن بايك سلام أن يقيم بحاجة من حاجاته فلا بأس. إن شاء الله صدقة. If the person is busy, the imam is doing the Jumu'ah, and assalamu alaikum, assalamu alaikum, he only has a few minutes to get back to his job. No problem. He has to get back to his family. The sister's there, she has to get back to her family. The brother, the sister, has something that they had to attend to. It's an emergency, it's a must. So they leave the masjid. La bas, that's fine. But I can have a laysa hala kathirin minna. Wallah. But that's not the situation of most of us, ikhwan. That's a few. Everybody can't be that busy. لا. فأحيانا يا أخوان علينا أن نتوقف ونتنفس. Sometimes يا أخوان it's upon us to just stop. It can't be dunya. It can't be. Sometimes you just gotta take a moment. Sometimes you just have to take a breath. Just relax. Let the dunya go. Whatever is written for you, يا أخوان, is going to reach you. Whatever is not written for you is never going to reach you. طيب فتعلمنا أيضا We also learn, ya ikhwan, shay'an yata'allaqu bil-Qur'an. We also learn something that's connected to the Qur'an.
It's the word of Allah.
Allahu Akbar. Huwa kalam Allah. It's the speech of Allah. Minhu bada wa minhu ya'ud. Wa la yu'taburu makhluqan. It's the speech of Allah. It began from Allah. Returns to Allah. It's Allah's speech. And is not created. Wa hadha muhim. And that's important, ya ikhwan. Kathirun min al-Muslimin al-Yawm. يعتقدون أن القرآن مخلوق وهذا لا يصح ولا يجوز وإذا العبد يعتقد به فهذا كفر فهذا كفر Many of the Muslims of today unfortunately believe that the Quran is created Not only is this not allowed it's not correct it's haram to have that belief but if he believes it not he's a blind follower he's just saying what his father's saying he heard his sheikh say it So he's also from that country. So he just repeats it. Not like that. He truly believes that. And that's the belief of disbelief. وَهَذَا يُخْرِجُهُ عَنِ الْمِلَّةِ And that's the belief that can remove a person from the folds of Islam. وَهَذَا مُهِمْ أَيْضًا يَا إِخْوَانِ لِلَعَبْدِ أَنْ يَعْلَمَ يُمْكِنُهُ أَنْ يَمُوتَ عَلَى أَحَدِ حَالَيْنِ عَلَى أَحَدِ حَالَيْنِ Also, it's important, ya ikhwan, for us, the Muslim, may Allah make all of us Muslims, ya ikhwan, that the Muslim understands that there are two ways he can die. هو أسلم بحمد الله ويعبد ربه تعالى حمد الله ويحاول أن يتبع سنة النبي عليه السلام بحمد الله. The man accepted Islam. I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah, and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. He's a Muslim, and then he worships Allah. Alhamdulillah. And he follows the sunnah to the best of his ability. Alhamdulillah. عليه أن يعلم يمكنه أن يموت على أحد حالين. And still, it's upon him to know, although he accepted Islam, he still can die one or two ways. وأحدهما المطلوب. والثاني نعوذ بالله تعالى من هذه الحالة. And one of these two is the intent, is that which is encouraged, that which is hoped, that which is sought after that he dies as a
believer,
Muslim. And the second way we seek refuge with Allah Ta'ala from that situation when the Muslim dies as a Muslim. فَيَقُولُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى As Allah Ta'ala says في سورة البقرة وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ Allah Ta'ala says and do not die except that you're Muslim. Do not die except that you're in a state of an Islam. As-su'al al-awwal, man al-mutakallim. Question number one. Who is the speaker here? Who is saying this?
Allah.
The answer is Allah. Was-su'al al-thani, man hum al-mukhatabun. Question number two. Who is Allah addressing?
All humanity.
The Muslims?
The believers.
Believers.
Here Allah's not talking to the disbelievers. You go back to the beginning of the verse. Allah's not talking to Jami'a and Nas, Jami'a and Makhluqat.
In this specific ayah.
In this specific ayah here. Allah is not talking to the disbelievers here. No. He's not talking to all of mankind here. No. Sometimes Allah addresses the disbelievers. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ Say to them, O Muhammad, O you who disbelieve. That excludes the believers. Sometimes Allah Ta'ala is talking to the Prophet. Sometimes Allah Ta'ala is talking to the Prophets in general. Sometimes he's talking to someone specific. طيب اذهبا أي موسى وهارون إلى فرعون ولا تخافا إن فإني معكما طيب سورة طه أسمع وأرى سورة طه As Allah Ta'ala says talking to موسى and هارون Go both of you اذهبا هذا أمر للمثنى في اللغة العربية In the Arabic language this is a command for two people اذهبا You're talking to two people, you say اذهبا One man, اذهب One female, اذهبي Three or more men, اذهبوا Three or more women, اذهبنا طيب Allah Ta'ala here is talking to two people The proof is The شكلتا أو شكلتا الكلمة The shape of the word اذهبا This alif in the Arabic language is called alif al-ithnain The alif of two people اذهبا اجلسا كلا اخرجا. You're talking to two people. Go, sit, get out. طيب. Allah's talking to Musa and Harun. Go to Fir'aun, don't be afraid. For verily I, meaning Allah, I am with you. I hear, or I'm with you with my hearing, my vision. طيب, Surah Taha. المهم, the point here is what? Allah Ta'ala أحياناً يخصص بعض المخلوقات في الكلام. The point here is sometimes, yes, Allah specifies and He's speaking to certain groups, certain people. But in this ayah, من بداية الآية, يقول تعالى, يا أيها الذين آمنوا. Allah Ta'ala says, fear all you who believe. So Allah Ta'ala is talking to the believers. So He's commanding them, He's prohibiting them from what? أن لا يموتون إلا وهم مسلمون. Allah is telling the believers, do not die except that you are Muslim. فيبين الله تعالى لنا في هذه الآية أن المسلم يمكنه أن يموت مسلما وكافرا. So in this ayah, وعليك السلام, in this verse here, إخوان, Allah is warning the believer. He's teaching, illustrating the belief to the believer that he can die one of two ways. As a believer and as a disciple. فَكَيْفَ الْعَبْدُ لَا يَمُوتُ كَافِرًا. So what's the way that a believer cannot die as a disbeliever? The best way. Or from the best ways. How can he try his best not to die as a disbeliever? What can he do?
Follow the Quran and Sunnah.
Follow the book of Allah and the Sunnah. إذا العبد يتبع الكتاب والسنة اتباعا حقا اتباعا حقا سيموت مؤمنا مسلما بإذن الله تعالى. If the servant of Allah truly, listen to my words, truly, not like most of us, I'm Muslim, he never prays. I'm Muslim, he never fasts. I'm Muslim. No, not like that. The true following. Not the man that's trying to follow and he sins and he repents. It happens. Alhamdulillah. Not like that. The one who truly follows the book of Allah. This is one of the best ways to assure yourself that you're going to die as a Muslim. The book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger. You use the Quran and Sunnah as your guide. It's one of the best ways. You guys are traveling down 95. You see the exit signs. You got your GPS on. That's your guide. The Muslim says, no, all I need is the Quran and Sunnah. Someone is talking, his speech, يُخَالِفُ الْكِتَابَ وَسُنَّةِ فَهُوَ يَتُرُكُ هَذَا. لماذا؟ لأنه يُخَالِفُ الْكِتَابَ وَسُنَّةِ. Someone is talking, no matter who it is, your sheikh, my sheikh, me, you, my father, your father. مَهْمَا كَانَ مِنَ النَّاسِ, whoever the person is, he mentions some speech that opposes the Quran and Sunnah. I'm not with that. That's your father. Yes. My father taught me, if I go against the Quran and Sunnah, don't follow me. Where did he get that from? The Quran and Sunnah. If myself, we say something, may Allah forbid, that is not from the Quran and Sunnah, we don't expect you to follow it. If it becomes clear to me, I'm not going to follow it. How much more so you? So someone is speaking, no matter how beautiful the speech is, and it happens. Farrakhan. I don't like to mention names, Ikhwan. That was a slip of the tongue. على كل فاركان يتكلم بأسلوب جميل إذا العبد يسمع إلي وأنا لا أنصحكم سمعا أو استماعا إلي ولكن إذا العبد يسمع إلي سيجد أن أسلوبه جميل أسلوبه جميل. For example, there's a man from the Nation of Islam in America. His name is Louis Farrakhan. I don't like to mention names, as I mentioned. Allah Ta'ala decreed that the name came out of my mouth. طيب. At any rate, and I'm not saying listen to the man. That's not my Islam. But if a person listens to him, especially in politics, mashallah, he's going to find that he has a beautiful manner of speaking. Islam speaks about the truth. If something is the truth, we affirm it. Alhamdulillah. Not religiously, his manner. Before the people in Chester try to switch my words up, I know where I'm at. Oh, now the brother's trying us to be on the Nation. That's not my Islam. Master Sintu was trying to tell us, now we got to be on the Nation. Not like that, Ikhwan. At any rate, he has a good manner, a beautiful manner of speaking. That happens. The Prophet of Allah used to seek refuge with Allah Ta'ala From the munafiqun, alimul lisan. From the hypocrite that has a beautiful tongue. The Prophet is referring to that. A person can speak beautifully. And then you say, man, he ain't saying nothing. But it sounds good. A couple big words. He slowed down, sped up, screamed a little, came back down, engaged the audience. MashaAllah, he has a good manner. What is he talking about? I have no idea. Not one. That happens, ya ikhwan. That happens. Sometimes you're walking down, you see those people that knock on your door, and you listen to them. The Jehovah's Witness. I don't know if you have them in Chester. The Jehovah's. Usually all you gotta say when they knock on your door is, Ana min al-Muslimin. Alhamdulillah, yatruku ka ba'da dhalik. They knock on your door, you say, I'm from the Muslim. They say, oh, have a good day. They understand the Muslims know what they're talking about. But usually, sometimes, often, they may try to speak with you. You say, this lady speaks nice. Alhamdulillah. What is she talking about? She doesn't even know. But it sounds nice. The point is, Islam is never about the beauty of one's speech. If whatever anyone is saying, يُوَافِقُ الْكِتَابَ وَالسُنَّةِ فَهُوَ الْكَلَامُ مَأْخُوذُ وَكَلَامُ مَأْخُوذُ. Anyone's speech, like it who likes it, hate it who hates it. If it agrees with Quran and Sunnah, that speech is taken. وَهَذَا الْقَاعِدَةِ. And that's a principle. If it agrees with Quran and Sunnah, you take it. Shukran. Barakallahu feek. وَلَوْ صَدَرَ مِنْ الشَّيْطَانِ. نكرر هذا. وَلَوْ صَدَرَ هَذَا الْكَلَامُ مِنْ الشَّيْطَانِ. Even if Shaitan said it. We can take from Shaitan? Yes. Are you sure we can take from Shaitan? Yes. With one condition. When he's right. Sometimes Shaitan is right, ya khwan. انظروا إلى القرآن. Look at the Quran. Assalamu alaikum. If he's right. أحيانا الشيطان قوله يوافق الكتابة وسنة.
And there's a story that he advised Musa عليه السلام.
وأبي هريرة. Many times, ya khwan. Shaitan, sometimes his speech is in accordance with Quran and Sunnah. أولا وأبدا عندما يحلف بالله. هذا الأمر الأول. Every time, don't take my word, you go to the Quran. We don't teach no one to take from us. Who are we, Ikhwan? No, you take from the Quran and Sunnah. When you go to the Quran and Sunnah, when Shaitan swears, he only swears by Allah. He never not swears by Allah. يقول الشيطان فبعزتك لأغوينهم أجمعين إلا عبادتك منهم المخلصين. Allah Ta'ala, he says about Shaitan, that Shaitan says, O Allah, Shaitan, O Allah, I swear by your might. Shaitan, mashallah. Sounds like a Muslim. Sounds like a Muslim, right? That Shaitan. O Allah, فبعزتك, I swear by your might. لأغوينهم أجمعين. I'm going to mislead all of them. MashaAllah. Look at the speech. What's the point? He's swearing by Allah. Shaitan only swears by Allah. Many of us, I swear on my mother's grave. That's us. Have the shirk. That's shirk. I swear on my father. Have the shirk. Many of us, I swear on... To swear by the creation?
On my mama.
On my mother. One brother said, man, that hadith is weak, and I swear by my mom. Have the shirk. You just committed shirk with Allah Ta'ala. Shaitan doesn't even do that. Shaitan knows. When I swear, I only swear by Allah. وذكر بخاري حديثا عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه عن قصة في رمضان. And Bukhari mentions a narration that's about hadith narrated by Abu Huraira, and which in the time of Ramadan, وضع النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام رجلا على الكنز على صدقة كنز صدقة. When the Messenger of Allah appointed a man in charge of the sadaqah, the treasure of the sadaqah, and that man was Abu Huraira. And then the first or second night, Abu Huraira mentions, أتى رجلا وحاول أن يسرق. He said a man came and he tried to take the money. Abu Huraira was in charge of the money in sadaqah. You gotta have somebody to watch the sadaqah, Yaquan, especially nowadays. So the Prophet put Abu Huraira in charge. And then he said, a man came and tried to take it. I grabbed him.
I was about to take him to the Prophet of Allah. And he said, Lala, don't take me. Don't take me to the Messenger of Allah. So Abu Hurairah let him go. The man came back a second time, a third time, tried to take the money again. Abu Hurairah akhadahu, seized him. Now I'm taking you to the Messenger of Allah. That's it. On his way to the Messenger of Allah, he said, if you don't take me to the Messenger of Allah, ufiduka shay'an, I'll give you a benefit. Shaytan. It's not clear as shaytan yet. It's a man, a shaytan in the form of a man. Abu Hurairah says, you're going to give me a benefit? He says, na'am. Ufiduka shay'an, I'll give you a benefit. If you don't take me to the Prophet of Allah, I'll give you a benefit. Shaytan. But it's not clear shaytan yet. At the end, it becomes clear. Abu Hurairah says, Tada. He says, Iqra ayat al-Qursi. قبل أن تنام فالله تعالى يحافظ يحفظك الله تعالى عن الشيطان حتى أن تصبح أو كما قال أبو هريرة. So the man says, if you recite Ayatul Kursi before you go to sleep, Allah Ta'ala is going to protect you against shaitan. He's shaitan in the form of a man. If you recite Ayatul Kursi, one verse, before you go to sleep, Allahu Akbar, Allah is going to protect you from shaitan until you wake up. Shaitan can't come to you if you recite Ayatul Kursi. So Abu Hurairah, ماذا فعل? What did he do?
He let him go.
ثم ماذا? Then what did he do after that? Allahu Akbar. أتي إلى النبي. He went to the Prophet to verify. وهذا يدل على فضل أهل العلم وعلى فضل العلم وعلى فضل الفهم الصحيح للنصوص. And this shows many benefits, ya ikhwan. Abu Hurairah is going back to the Messenger of Allah to ascertain the knowledge, to verify, shows the virtues of the people of knowledge. The people of knowledge. Ayna nahnu min ahli ilm. Where are we from the people of knowledge? There used to be something that we used to do in America every week. Fi ayyi masjidin ma, idha kana hadhihi al-masjidu min as-sunnah. We used to do this when we were new Muslims, mashallah. Weekly, in every masjid, if the masjid was on the sunnah. وهذا عندما يجتمع المسلمون في المسجد وأن يتصلوا بأحد من العلماء وأن يسألوه أسئلة ثم يجيبه الشيخ وهذا أمر عظيم. Where in every masjid on the sunnah, that's the one condition, if the masjid was on the sunnah, the Muslims would choose a day from the week. They would come together. No arguing, no fighting. Alhamdulillah, everyone's brothers today. Allahu Akbar. No one does this no more. Only a few masajids still do this. And they would contact one of the scholars of Al-Islam on the sunnah. And any question that they would have, they would ask the scholars. And this is something that's a sunnah of the Messenger of Allah. This is something that's highly, 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 highly recommended. بأن يتصل بأئمة المساجد لا بطلبة العلم لا بأي أحد من الناس لا بمن وضعهم الله تعالى في هذه المسؤولية. But they will contact the ones that Allah placed in charge of this responsibility, the scholars. We have class every week. We start writing down the questions that maybe we can't handle those questions, or even if we can handle them to the best of our ability. وفوق كل عليم وفوق كل ذي علم العليم. And above everyone that has some knowledge is the all-knower, as Allah Ta'ala says. طيب. So we take all the questions that we get throughout the week. And one day we contact some of the scholars. It's something that every masjid should do. No one should feel that he has all the knowledge. You memorize every hadith out? Yes. A'udhu Billah. It's impossible. No scholar alive, no scholar who's ever walked the face of the earth has memorized every hadith. Bukhari, hafidha jami' al-hadith? La. Imam al-Bukhari, one of the most memorized scholars Islam has ever witnessed, did he memorize every hadith? The answer is no, ya ikhwan. Shaykhuhu Ahmed, one of his greatest scholars was Al-Imam Ahmed. Min hufadhi hadhihi al-umma ayda, from the greatest memorizers of this nation also, Bukhari and his Shaykh Ahmed. Hal nafhamu annahu hafidha jami'a al-ahadith? Al-jawabu la. Do we understand that Ahmed memorized every hadith out? The answer is of course not, ya ikhwan. There's no such person. Ibn Taymiyyah says, if you believe that there's a scholar that memorized, he has all the knowledge, he has all the hadith, only him, then this is an innovation. You believe there's only one scholar out. That's most of us. This one sheikh, he's the only one. We love the scholars. We have to love the scholars. You're not a Muslim. A correct Muslim. A complete Muslim. حتى أن نحب العلماء. Unless we love the scholars, ya ولكن لا نقلدهم. لا. But we don't blind follow them. ولا نظلمهم. Nor do we oppress them. ولا ننقصهم. Nor do we diminish their value. لا لا لا. نضعهم بمنزلة حقا لهم. حقا لهم. But we place the scholars in the level, in a station, in a platform that's correct. نحبهم ولكن نحبهم حبا شرعيا. We love the scholars. We have to. But how do we love them? With an Islamic love. We love them Islamically. We don't love them above their levels. What does that mean? We make the scholars like the prophets and messengers? La 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 la. هذا ظلم. That's oppression. As one scholar was asked a question about another scholar. And he said, yeah, Ikhwan, you brothers in the West, is as if y'all making this scholar that we love like the Prophet of Allah. Like one brother from the West asked the Sheikh, one of the major scholars of today that I can't forget, I can't remember his name, Ikhwan al-An, Sheikh al-Rajihi, Sheikh Abdulaziz al-Rajihi, Hafidhullah Ta'ala. They asked him a question about another scholar. The Sheikh said, Nuhibbuhu, we love him. Who is Sheikhuna? He's our Sheikh. ولكن كأنكم كأنه عندكم بمنزلة النبي ونعوذ بالله. The Sheikh said, but to you brothers in the West, it's as if to you, this scholar that we love, he's like the Prophet of Allah. And that's not correct. So we love the scholars. We don't believe that they're infallible. We don't believe that, ya ikhwan. You're going to make an error. The scholars are going to make error. You're going to make an error. I'm going to make an error. You're human.
Like these two brothers, just today they told me, they were arguing. And he was saying, the Prophet said, he said, well, my sheikh said, and he was like, astaghfirullah, I'm telling you, the Prophet said.
Yeah. How can you mention today anyone, not even a companion, in front of the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam? And another benefit we wanted to mention, to use knowledge against knowledge is not from the Sunnah. To use a verse against another verse is kufr. يقول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام الجدال عن الجدال عن القرآن كفر أو كما قال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. To argue with regards to the Quran is disbelief. What does this mean? The brother gives you an ayah and you're going to argue that ayah with another ayah, and then you give him an ayah, he's going to argue that ayah with another. That's disbelief. None of the people of knowledge do that. No one. But to clarify, that's something else. But to argue the verse with another verse, you mention a hadith, you're going to follow that with a scholar? La, la, la. This is the Prophet of Allah. Follow. You guys with me?
No, I'm just saying, you said, like, an
issue comes up. Whatever the issue. You bring a verse, the brother's going to bring another verse to refute your verse. That's not correct, yeah. All the Quran is connected. طيب. At any rate, ikhwan, many of us, we love the scholars, but we love them with a love of hizbiyah, shakhsiyah, of partisanship, or personality worship. I love that sheikh. Why do you love him? He's from a country that I'm from. That's not from Islam. He's white looking. Many of us have racism and we don't even know it. Many of us. I remember I was applying for a job at a masjid. I don't know if I can say that or not. I guess you could say that. And the brothers thought I was born in a country in Africa. I'm from Africa. I claim I'm from Africa. I believe that. I don't know exactly where. But I believe I'm African. Somewhere in Sudan. Inshallah. I'm African descendant. So the brothers, you know, I try to speak some Arabic sometimes. May Allah increase us and all. So the brothers in the administration that I was applying for, everything was going well. And then someone said, oh, alhamdulillah, the brother was born in America. And everything went south. No, this is a true story. Wow. Everything was going good. Oh, alhamdulillah, brother's from Africa. Alhamdulillah. He was in Yemen for a little bit. He's back in America giving da'wah. Alhamdulillah, everything is good. The job was mine. So somehow somebody said, oh, I know the brother. Yeah, he went to Ben Franklin High School. They said, where? He's not an African? I said, no, he was born in Philadelphia. And then next thing you know, they took my... ripped that contract up. At any rate, some of us have racism, ikhwan, classism. And we don't even see it. We don't even see it. Some of their brothers, the Arab, some of the Africans, even us, the African Americans, if you want to use that type of label, ikhwan. At any rate, when someone touches your foot, say, oh, look at that black foot. I'm not touching that black foot. And it's hard. That's not Islam comes to unite the people, ikhwan. Not any farriqahum, not to divide them. Anything that's any argument, any ikhtilafat, Islam can come and solve it. If you allow it. Any argument we may have, whatever the issue is, if it's truly Islamic and it's not personal, Oh, he got the car, he knew I wanted that car. That's many of our arguments are futile arguments. He knew that's the van I wanted. I saved up all my income taxes. For 3 years, I go to the store, I go to the lot, not the store, I go to the lot, one car left. He knew I wanted that car. MashaAllah. He has four of them. He has a car, his wife has a car. That's how many of us. His son has a car, the daughter has a car. I don't have no car. He could have gave me that car. Wait till next Jumu'ah, I'm not giving him no salams. That's how we are. Or his family makes the dinner for Ramadan. My family asks, can I also help? No, we don't really want to mix the food. This is from brother such and such. He has an issue with anyone bringing food. He don't want no one to think that bad food is from him. Let anyone bring food who wants to bring food. He didn't sign up on a list. Alhamdulillah. What's the issue? Why is there a list anyway? Anyone who wants to bring some food can bring some food. But my wife is a chef. His wife works at McDonald's. Alhamdulillah. Maybe your wife's food is better. That's not the point. So she can't bring no food? Islam comes to unite the people, ikhwan. Any argument, you name the issue. Praying with your hands to the side, hands on the chest. Alhamdulillah. Is this from Islam? Yes. Let's sit down and discuss. This sheikh said, this madhab says. No problem. You're right, perhaps. I got one question and one question only, and then my argument is done. I've been talking for 25 minutes. You want to ask me one question? Yes. Go here, brother. Did the Prophet pray like that? Oh, you arrogant. You brother. No, did the Prophet pray with his hands to the sides or on his chest? There's no narration that the Prophet of Allah ever prayed like that. Not one. And every scholar who mentions it's a sunnah, they never say the Prophet said. They never say the Prophet did. Not one. And for those that follow the Maliki Madhab, the correct opinion with them is al-dhum, laysa al-irsal. The people who follow the Maliki Madhab, in reality, the correct opinion with them is that you place your right hand on your left. With the Maliki Madhab, starting from their greatest Imam, Al-Imam Malik, himself. لَهُ كِتَابٌ عَظِيمٌ جِدًّا كَتَبَهُ بِيَدِهِ. There's a tremendous book that I encourage all of us to study. It's one of the best books of al-hadith, one of the best books of al-fiqh you're ever going to learn. Maybe one day we hope we can read this book together as a masjid. One of the best books you're going to learn. One volume. Alhamdulillah. We can do it. One volume. It's called Al-Muwatta by Imam Malik. He wrote it himself. له في هذا الكتاب كتاب تحت باب كتاب الصلاة. In this book, Al-Muwatta, he has a chapter called The Book of Prayer. Don't take my word, ya ikhwan. Go to the book. In this book, you're going to open the book. You're going to see Book of Purification, Book of Fasting, Book of Salah. When you get to the Book of Salah, iftahu, open it up. ستجد بابا يسمى باب الصلاة أو قصر الصلاة في سفر. You're going to find the chapter shortening the prayer while you're traveling. ثم ذكر نفس الحديث الذي ذكره البخاري. Then he mentions the same hadith that Bukhari mentions. Hadith by Sa'd, that he says, في أحد النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام كان رجل يؤمر أن يضع يده اليمنى على يده اليسرى في الصلاة. And he brings the same hadith that Bukhari brings, narrated by Sa'd, that he said, in the time of the Messenger of Allah, a man was commanded to place his right hand on his left hand in the prayer. Another thing that's humbling, those that say that Imam Malik says that placing the irsal, placing your hands to the side, is a sunnah. In his whole book, he doesn't bring one hadith to support that. Not one. But the position that they say he's against, placing your right on your left, he brings a hadith to support it. The proofs are there, Yaquan. Don't let anyone stir you away from the truth. It's there. But you have to do your research. You have to go back to the books of hadith. That's why we always encourage the brothers, especially in Chester, to write the knowledge down. Unless you have a memory like Sufyan al-Thawri, or Abu Hatim al-Razi, or al-Bukhari, or Waqi' ibn Jarrah. If you have a memorization like these great imams, لَيْسَ عَلَيْكَ أَن تَكْتُبَ شَيْئًا مَا لِأَنَّكَ سَتَحْفَظُ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. Because if you have a memory like them, you don't have to write anything down. Because you're going to memorize everything. Like Imam Waqi' ibn Jarrah. Man hadha? Who was his great Imam, Yaquan? Waqi' ibn Jarrah. Ihfadhu hadha al-ism. Memorize that name, Yaquan. Waqi' ibn Jarrah. Huwa shaykhun min shuyukhi al-Imam al-Shafi'i. He's a scholar from the teachers of Imam al-Shafi'i. Wa yuqalu a'tfadhu.
Is that the poetry? Arabic wasaltu waqi'in?
Ay, ahsan.
So, sahih, yes?
Ay, sahih. That's correct. Waqi' ibn Jarrah. He's the one that, as the Sheikh alluded to, there's some famous poetry that a Shafi'i mentions his name. And that's the story we're getting into.
Shafi'i mentioned Waqi'.
So a Shafi'i, hifdhuhu azim. A Shafi'i, no one's ignorant of a Shafi'i. This is one of the greatest scholars you're ever going to learn about. Even our children. You say a Shafi'i, oh, he's going to say Abu Abdullah. The child is going to say that. Even our children know about a Shafi'i. The cat, you guys have a cat out there? That little cat. He knows about a Shafi'i. Alhamdulillah. Everyone knows about a Shafi'i.
Maybe
about
Hurairah.
So now, hey, a Shafi'i has a great memory.
Is it, this is, Sheikh, I'm sorry to cut you. Is it that poetry? Shakaytu ila waki'in su'a hibli.
No.
So that was the Shafi'i.
No.
SubhanAllah, all that time.
So a Shafi'i said about himself, when I read something once, Alhamdulillah, kana fi qalbi. Allahu Akbar. Shafi said about his own self, from Allah Ta'ala, if I read something one time, I got it. A Shafi was one of the ones that when he went into the marketplace, he would cover up his own ears, not to memorize the speech of the people, not to memorize the music and the likes. He would cover his own ears. You go into Walmart, and he's shopping like this. Not to hear the Tupac, the Biggie, the Jay-Z. He was afraid of that. Not like many of us. We're trying to memorize it. The Muslim nowadays, he's in his car memorizing the songs. Not like that. He's trying not to memorize it. We're having rap battles. That's us. No, not like that. It's hard enough not to listen to it. So why memorize it? So this great imam was trying not to memorize the nonsense. Used to put one hand on another page to cover it up while he's memorizing a book. So that his eyes wouldn't go there, and then he confuses the text. If he read it, he got it. Allah, one of the greatest memorizers you're ever going to read about, Yaquan. So one day he says, a woman, there's always a woman. A woman passes by. And not like many of us, he didn't check her out. And then like most of us, what do most of us do? Not only check the girl out, what's the biggest sin that we do?
Stare at her.
No, even more, greater than staring at her.
What is
it
when we say the first one is for me?
No, more than all of that. Most of us, not some. This is most of us.
Whistle.
No, greater than that, Yaquan.
Flirt?
No, greater than that. We encourage the sin. She's walking past. Some of us are going to say, don't look across the street, Yaqi. Don't do it. Fear Allah.
That's some of us. That's some. One of the brothers, we're all outside. 1, 2, 3, 4, all 10 of us. Some of the sisters pass by. One brother's going to say, Itaqillah, ya ikhwan. One brother. Alhamdulillah. The rest of us are going to break our necks. For example. And then most of us are going to do what? Oh, yo, check it out. Such and such is coming. We're going to encourage it. It's not enough to do the sin. No, many of us, I'm going to help you sin. That's the worst. If you sin, sin by yourself. Don't encourage no one to sin. Yo, don't look across the street. Little Cindy is coming down the street. Oh, yeah. Tell him, don't fear Allah. Lower your gaze. Encourage what's correct. Encourage what's correct. Try your best. Turn your back. For example, sometimes the woman come, you gotta run away. That's fine. At any rate, so Imam Shafi, one time the woman passed by, he didn't check her out. He lowered his gaze, but he noticed her foot, her ka'ab, her ankle bone. MashaAllah, may Allah make us better, ikhwan. So he was affected by the ankle, the foot of the woman, the foot. He said, now I notice, since I noticed her foot, now I got to read it 3 times. Because the sin affected him. Sins affect. Sins affect the ikhwan. Sometimes you have a good memory, then you commit a sin, and you commit a sin, and you commit a sin, and you wonder, why can't I review Quran no more? Why can't I get up at night like I used to? Why is it so hard for me to listen to Tupac now? Why? I never listened to him before. Now I'm in a Walmart, like, oh, this is my song. Billah. I never was like that before. Now all of a sudden, that beat is has a nice rhyme to it, and you find a Muslim like this now. Play. Now he's affected by the sin. He used to come to the masjid, used to be the first one there, open up, sweep it up, vacuum. Now he's barely there, except on Jumu'ah. Then now he's only on the Eid. And now he's late for the Eid. And now he doesn't even care about the Eid. Sins affect the ikhwan. They affect. So he looked at the foot of the girl and it affected his memory. He said about his own self, now I got to read it 3 times. So if that's this great imam, what about us? That's why we can't memorize nothing. That's why most of the brothers, every week you make announcements. Class to this week. The brother, alhamdulillah, come to the masjid. Hey, it's class. Yes. Oh, what day? What day are you free? Tuesdays. Class is Tuesdays. Oh, I can't make it. That's most of us. The one brother, when I used to do Jumar here, every time I see him, he asks the same question. I can tell you what he's going to say when he's coming. He's going to say, how's everything? What day is class? Wa alaikum salam to Allah. Everything's good. Class is Wednesday. Oh, man, if y'all only had it on Friday. That's why we made the class Friday, because of him. He's the main reason. He said, why don't you make the class on Friday? I'm free Friday. I said, okay, I'll talk to the brothers. What about Friday? Friday is good. Go back to that brother. Class is Friday now. He said, oh, I just got a raise. That's most of us. It don't matter what day you say, he's not going to come. He doesn't want to come. It's just conversation. The ones that are going to come are going to change their schedule around. Allahu Akbar. To come benefit. So now, the woman passed by, looked at her foot, affected by the sin. So Imam Ash-Shafi'i says about himself now. He goes to one of his greatest teachers, Imam Waqi' ibn Jarrah. يُقَالُ عَنْهُ أَنَّهُمْ لَا يَرَوْنَهُ كَاتِبَ شَيْئًا مَا مِنَ الْعِلَمِ. The scholars used to say about this great Imam, we never saw him write anything down. Never. He used to memorize everything. One of the greatest memorizers you're ever going to read about. Wakir. So Ash-Shafi'i ata ilayhi li yastansihahu. Nasihan. Nasihatan. So Ash-Shafi'i goes to him to get some advice from him. So Wakir says something amazing to his student Ash-Shafi'i. He says, if I tell you what I do, are you going to do it? It's no time to waste. You just can't come to these great imams and waste their time. Like many of us, yeah, alhamdulillah, how's everything? I got a question. Are you writing it down? No.
What's the benefit? If you're going to write it down, oh, I'm busy. One brother contacts you and says, listen, can I ask you a question? Yes. Can you give me the summarization of it? Say, hey, you ask me. If you don't have no time, wait till you're free and let's talk about the issue. Alhamdulillah. So he says, if I tell you what I do, are you going to do it? MashaAllah. Shafi, yes. So, Imam Wakir says to him, to leave off the sins. That's it. And then he says, فَعِلْمُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى لَا يُعْطَى إِلَى عَاصِي. He says, for indeed the knowledge of إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ نُورٌ وَلَا يُعْطَى اللَّهُ تَعَالَى وَلَا يُعْطِى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى الْعِلْمَ لِلْعَاصِي. Or كما قال. He says, for indeed knowledge is a light. And Allah will never give the light of knowledge to a sinner. And this is humbling to even say, ya ikhwan. Forget the brothers listening. To say the likes of that, when we know the sins that we do, myself, and you wonder, this is why I'm not knowledgeable. This is why Allah hasn't allowed us to be memorizers. This is why, because of our sins, ya ikhwan. So it's not only humbling to hear, humbling to say. The thing that's stopping you from learning, stopping me from learning, stopping us from learning, is our own sins. So this great Imam is telling Ash-Shafi'i, if you leave off the sins, you really want to be a memorizer? You want to be a great imam, a scholar, a big student of knowledge one day? Then leave off sins to the best of your ability. You're going to sin, you're human, but now you're not going to sin as regularly. You're going to sin rarely, seldomly, often. Not often, seldomly. So he says, leave off the sins. So Ash-Shafi'i says, one day, شكوت وكيع عن سوء حفظي فأرشدني إلى ترك المعاصي فقال إن العلم نور ولا يعطى العلم عاصي أو كما قال الشافعي رحمه الله. Then a Shafi mentions a piece of poetry, a two or three line piece of poetry, and he says one day he summed up everything we just said in a poetry form in two or three lines. He says, شكوت وكيع عن, I complain to Imam Wakiع about the weakness of my memory. And this is a man that if he reads it three times, he has it. But to him, that's weak. That's weak. We have to recite it 200, 300, 400 times. Three times he has it. So he says, وَقَوْتُ شَكَوْتُ وَكِيعًا سُوَ حِفْظِي فَأَرَشَدْنِي إِلَى تَرَكِ الْمَعَاصِي. So he said, I complained about my memory to Imam Wakir, and he advised me, he instructed me to leave off the sins. And he said, for indeed this knowledge is a light, and this light will never be given to a sinner. And wallahi, that's true, ya ikhwan. You brothers can be the difference. Don't worry about this masjid is against this masjid, those brothers against these brothers. Don't worry about that, ya ikhwan. There's no benefit in that. If you're going to give them advice, give them advice. After you give them advice, keep it moving. And focus on memorizing. You got brothers that are strong in Quran here. Sheikh Hani, our beloved brother from Afriki. Ifriqa, and other brothers, alhamdulillah, also. Grab them. Go over some Quran with them. Sheikh Fadl from Yemen, alhamdulillah. Other many brothers, that these are the ones that come to my mind, ya ikhwan, at this moment. You can grab a book of hadith, a small book of hadith, and try to memorize it. Find someone to teach you Arabic. And we've been trying to do some Arabic classes here for a year and a half. We try our best, ya ikhwan, to keep on going. At any rate, you brothers can be the difference. Next thing you know, these brothers are like great imams. Now, when Sabiqun needs someone to give the Jumu'ah, we got brothers to send over there. And we know they're going to teach the Sunnah, because they have learned the Sunnah. Alhamdulillah. This masjid over there needs a brother. Alhamdulillah. Sheikh such and such, go. Now when the imam is caught in traffic, everyone is not crying now. Everyone is not nervous. Who's going to do the Jumu'ah? Brothers stepping out, going to their car, so they won't get chosen. Alhamdulillah. Now you're ready for your turn to be called. Alhamdulillah. At any rate, you brothers can be the difference, ya ikhwan. I think our beloved brother Thabit has something to say. If not, we'll stop.
When you said you make a lot of sins.
All of us, yeah.
Then you don't remember things. Say if you stop making a lot of sins, you'll remember.
There's some scholars that say, ikhwan, that there are different foods. Ibn Qayyim mentions some foods to strengthen your memory. From them, he mentions dark chocolate.
At any rate, some people mention fruits, grapes, that little red fruit. What's that fruit? Not the strawberry. When you bust it open, it got a lot of the pomegranate. At any rate, there's no proof of none of that. But they are good fruits. Alhamdulillah. They get the blood cells flowing like this. But there's no proof that chocolate helps your memory. There's no proof from the Quran and Sunnah.
You just say Tarkul Ma'asi. That's a proof.
Hey, that's the proof.
I think that makes sense. This more the than point. Eating pomegranate.
Yeah, that's
now people going, I'm going to keep listening to my music, but I'm going to eat the pomegranate. Not like that, Ikhwan. Because we got to remember that Allah Ta'ala is the same one that taught these great imams. It's not like they believed in another Allah. And we have another Allah. La, la, la. Allah Al-Wahid. Allah As-Samad. Allah Ta'ala is the same Allah. But they did the actions. And Allah Ta'ala blessed them. They were more sincere. They were more diligent. They sacrificed. Abu Huraira sacrificed his dunya. Chose to be poor. To be close to the Prophet ﷺ. To memorize the ahadith of the Messenger ﷺ. He wasn't like many of us. Where I just want to be rich. I want to be a ball player. Which is okay to be. He sacrificed that to preserve the hadith of the Messenger. And he went on to be one of the greatest or the most narrated companion from the companions of the Messenger. Nobody memorized hadith like him. Of course, the Prophet made dua for him. Allah Ta'ala blessed him. But look at what he sacrificed. Many of us can't sacrifice our food and our drink. So when are we ever going to memorize? Many of us, why you don't come to the masjid? It's too hot in the summer. Okay, wintertime comes. Why you don't come? Oh, now it's too cold. So when are you going to learn? When are you going to learn? Seeking knowledge, we're not going to be comfortable. We have to sacrifice. We can do it. We can start off a couple classes a day. We're going to start some books of hadith, inshallah ta'ala, soon. Start some Arabic. We want to make this place like a madrasa, where there's classes in Quran, class in hadith, class in aqeedah, class in fiqh. We could do it, Yahwan. Why can't we do it? What else are we doing? What else? We can do it, Yahwan. And we don't always need a bigger masjid. You take advantage of what you have. If Allah bless you with another building next year, the next year, alhamdulillah. Like one brother said in Westchester or somewhere near like that, they have a nice building. Nice. They want a bigger one. And then Allah's going to give them that. They go, no, it's not enough. We need a bigger one. For it to be empty. What's the point? Some masajid have 3 or 4 imams. Alhamdulillah. And none of them come. What's the benefit? Everyone has a key to the masjid. 20 copies of the key. That's not the point. The point is that we give out the keys so somebody can come open it. 20 keys out. And the ones that have the key, they don't come. What's the faida? There's no benefit. Then we get this big masjid. And this big masjid. And no one comes. But the masjid is beautiful, alhamdulillah. We got new fans, new this, new carpet. Alhamdulillah. What's the benefit? I'd rather have a raggedy masjid that's jam-packed than a beautiful masjid that's empty. And Ibn Abbas was against beautifying the masjid. Allahu Akbar. So we stopped there, Ikhwan. One of the brothers asked a question or so, but I don't follow the questions that good, Ikhwan. Our Sheikh says, because our minds are clouded with nonsense and this destroys our memories. That's correct too. I thought that was a question. Tayyib, so we stop there, Ikhwan. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaikum. What are you doing, buddy?
Me? Exercising? Part of the Sheikh?
Can't do that.
Never know Sheikh Naeem.
What's that?
No.
You can't even put your feet like that.
No,
overseas, they will kick you out from the class if you do that.
Because he has the shit.
You can't
do that in front of the Sheikh.
Yeah, from the bus is okay. I never know that. I always have. I always know the poet. Poetry that part.
But you didn't know what Shafi said.
Never know if the Shafi.
Hey, Shafi said that.
Mr. Wallah Al-Ali. I thought it was just a general. A funny name.
No, he's the man.
You've heard it before. I think the questions you were answering.
The kind of writing in his book.
Yeah, Shafi to Ila Wakia. You heard it before?
No.
Is that the name of the book?
Never?
I don't know the English name, but a lot of the English titles may be a name that the translator may give it.
But it may not be the actual title of the book. So y'all look at what the author wrote. No.
Oh, and I asked Sheikh Naim, but he was busy.
I think it was in Arabic they say عقب عقب مقدمي قدميها, like the heel of her foot.
Okay.
Is either her ankle or her heel?
Okay.
Anything Ibn Qayyim Yaquan is one of those scholars that if you see he wrote it, try to get it. It's going to benefit you a lot.
Today, what's wrong about getting the smoke you live today?
He's a scholar of everything.